Philippine Health Secretary Francisco Duque III assures the public Sinovac's COVID-19 vaccine is 100% effective in preventing severe symptoms of the disease. This amid concerns regarding the vaccine's effectiveness due to its low but acceptable 50.4% efficacy rate in Brazil. Duque points out the vaccine showed higher efficacy rates in Turkey and Indonesia.
Dapat tandaan natin, ang isa sa mga pinakamahalagang epekto ng bakuna, yung may iwasan mo yung malalang sakit na COVID. Eh, yung mga namamatay galing doon sa mga malalang sakit. O, pagka na iwasan mo yung severe o kaya malalang sakit ng COVID-19, ay hindi ka mamatay.
Duque also says government is making preparations for the expected arrival of Sinovac's vaccines from China this Sunday. The jabs will be brought to the health department storage facility in Marikina, which can store up to 500 million doses.
Wala doon naman gagawa na ng kanilang mga distribution channels, no?
Opo.
Yung sa mga ospital na paggagamitan at ganun din sa Visayas, Mindanao.
The Philippine Armed Forces says its members may choose not to get inoculated with Sinovac's vaccine if they refuse to, but they will have to pay for other COVID-19 vaccine brands. That's according to Armed Forces spokesperson Edgar Arevalo, who says Sinovac is the only brand allotted for them as of now. He notes if some soldiers want to opt out, then they may have to wait until authorities allow the commercial use of COVID-19 vaccines. But getting vaccinated with Sinovac will be compulsory for those who will help the country or with the country's vaccine rollout.
Para pong yung mga sundalo natin na binibigyan natin ng protective equipment sa paglaban, dahil harap nga po siya sa isang matinding kalaban, hindi po natin pwedeng payagan na maging optional kung gusto niyang magsuot ng hindi kung ito po ay bahagi at ito po ang available. Hindi dahil sa siya ay may duda o agam-agam sa force protection equipment, hindi niya ito susuot. These are part of our uniform, part of protecting our people.
100,000 of the 600,000 China-donated Sinovac doses will go to the armed forces. Arevalo says they are getting to make that targeting to vaccinate at least 100 personnel daily. A health advocacy group says there has to be better communication regarding COVID-19 vaccines to boost people's trust in the jabs. According to Dr. Josh San Pedro of the Coalition for People's Right to Health, much of the anxiety surrounding the vaccines stems from a lack of information and trauma from past vaccine issues. He says information on vaccines has to be brought down to the community level with a focus on transparency and accessibility. A survey by the Okta Research Group shows only 19% of Filipino adults are willing to get vaccinated against COVID-19.
Perhaps one of those convincing things is to have politicians and the local leaders to be vaccinated. No? So if it will help inspire trust, it will help inspire confidence for a lot of individuals to see that their own leaders or people who should be accountable to them, as well as who can set an example, if people do see these individuals being immunized.
In a best-case scenario, the AstraZeneca vaccine ordered by the city of Manila will arrive next month. The Philippine capital has secured 800,000 doses of AstraZeneca's jabs to inoculate 400,000 of its residents. Mayor Isko Moreno reiterated they will not force residents to get inoculated.
Sabi ko nga, sa atin sa Manila, pwede sila maging juicy, pwede sila magpagbakuna or later na lang, magantay na lang. Pwede sila makapamili, no? Pero siyempre hinihikayat natin na sa lalong madaling panahon na magpabakuna ang tao. Sa ngayon ay meron na tayong 90,000 na humigit kumulang, no, na gustong magpabakuna.
Meanwhile, Mayor Moreno supports a proposal to hold a one-day family day in his city's tourist attractions, which will allow those below 15 years old to visit open spaces with their families.